Hello YouTube, it is That So Brandon back with another Photoshop tutorial. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to improve your workflow within Photoshop using a function called Actions. Now, before about a year ago, I did not know that this function existed. For the past year, it definitely has saved me a lot of time when it comes to editing projects and working on things for other people or even just for myself, to make things flow a little bit faster. So again, I'm using Photoshop CS6. I do have the CC version. I find that runs really slow and it's very unreliable and it crashes a lot. So I'll stick with CS6 because it's what I know and it seems to work. So in this tutorial, as you can see, I have four photos of a subject that I shot photos for back on, I would say, probably about January 9th of 2017. And In these photos, I want to add what is referred to as a watermark, a little branding type deal so that I can go ahead and add all of my information. So if somebody likes the photos and that, for example, they want to get in contact with me, they can simply by just looking at the watermark and Googling Dark Trace Media, which is like an organization that I run of people here in the Niagara region. We'll get into that in a different video if anybody's interested in learning about that. So for example, what you're going to have here on the right hand side, you should have an Actions button. If for whatever reason you don't have that, you can always go up to Window, Actions, or hit Alt F9. That's also an option. So if you do that, it'll bring this up. I'm going to go ahead and create a new folder. You can call it whatever you want. For example, if you look at the screen, I already have Actions, Copyright, and Customs. I'm going to simply do Photoshop Tutorials now, and I'm going to create a new action with inside that. So inside this, I want this action again to be a branding, or most referred to as a watermark. So I'm just going to type in watermark graphic. And again, I do want to include that this can be graphics. If you rendered out graphics in Photoshop already, it can be images, it can be resizing, it could be actions, it could be brush strokes. It could be anything that you guys wanted in Photoshop. So watermark graphic, and I'm actually going to set a function key to F2. So every time I hit F2, this function will play out. Now I'm going to click record. Now that you're recording, anything and everything you do in Photoshop is going to be recorded. So please don't go crazy with it, because remember, as you hit play, it's going to take up CPU. And if you don't have that much of a powerful computer, kind of like me, it's going to slow things down a little bit. So for example, I'm just going to create a simple text layer and I'm going to be like Brandon Williamson. There. Oh, sorry. Brandon Williamson. All right. That's all I want. I don't want copyright. I'm just going to make this as simple and as basic as I can for this. So now I'm going to size it up a little bit just because I kind of want a bigger size. I want people to be able to see it, but don't worry. At the same time, I am keeping into consideration the fact that he's going to be posting these and he's going to want to use them as, you know, profile pictures, Instagram photos, whatnot. So just Brandon Williamson, simple enough. I'm going to click OK. It's going to go ahead. We're going to drag this down into the bottom corner here. And there you go. Now you can go and you can add your blending options, whether it's a stroke or a drop shadow. I generally use both. So I'm going to select black here for my stroke. I'm going to size that up a little bit just so that it pops out my name a little bit more. And I'm going to change the size of this. And I'm also going to change the spread a little bit. There you go. Now, for the last action that I want to include in this watermark is I want to go to the opacity and I want to change it down just a little bit. Enough where you can see it, but not enough where it's overpowering the actual object of the photo. So now if you go back into your actions window, whether you go to your window menu, you click the play button or you hit Alt F9, go ahead and click stop. Now, as I had mentioned, every time I hit the F2 key, this will happen. So if I go to this photo and I press F2, it's going to do all the exact same actions that I just did. Now, again, I don't have the best computer for this. So with that being said, it's going to go ahead and do that. I'm just going to drag layers and stuff all over the place here. So let's go to the background. Let's hit F2. Let's see if this works. It should be. Oh, it's reducing noise for some reason. All right, so I had that already set to a different action, and sadly, as you guys saw, there was no warning for it. So that is something that I would consider a little bit of a flaw with this. But for a watermark, Shift F2 is what it automatically changed to. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to hit Shift F2, and bam, your watermark is right there, right on top of the photo. Now, say you have 50 photos, you don't want to go and have to apply them to every single photo. Well, the good thing about Photoshop is you don't have to. If you simply, let's go ahead and delete these from both photos here. All right, so no watermark in any photos, as you can see. And I have 4 photos currently open that I want to apply this graphic or, branding or watermark to them. So I'm going to go up to File, Automate, Batch. And for example, I'm going to select Photoshop Tutorials and I'm going to click Watermark Graphic. Now I want them to do them all on the opened files. So that's already selected. Now you do need log errors to file. So just go ahead, choose a random directory for that. I currently never look at the errors log unless I absolutely have to. But now I'm going to click OK. So now for all the opened files, it's going to go really quick because it's just a simple text layer. And as you can see, it's already done. Now all these files already have this watermark added to them. So here we go. I'm going to go up to File, Scripts, Image Processor. Now this is how you save images all at once if you're working on multiple different images. So select the images to process. Use Open Images. That's what I have. And I'm going to just go ahead and put them on the desktop. It's very simple. And I'm going to save them as a JPEG quality 5. You can also save them as a PSD. Now, the other thing about this is you can also run an action while you're saving them. But I like to run the batch process so that if there's an error or if there's something that I want to go back and look at, I can do that simply just by going back and looking at the specific file. So I'm not going to run the action. You can type in copyright information if you want. I'm not exactly sure where that pops up, but I'm going to assume it's in the file metadata. So if that is the issue, whatever, I'm just going to leave it blank for this, for the point of this video, and I'm going to click run. Now it's going to run all these files and it's going to save them as only JPEG quality level 5, which is the absolute maximum quality for these photos that I'm able to do. Now keep in mind, I didn't do grain removal. I didn't do color correction on these. I didn't really do much for them. So now if I come back to my desktop and I open up these files here, it's going to be very, very simple. And as they open, you will see that they're rendered JPEG files in the highest quality format, which is level 5, and they will come up with the watermarks in them. Now, for some reason, it's taken a couple minutes to open, but again, I told you guys, I don't have the best computer. So I'm just going to right click on this photo and I'm going to open it with Windows Fax Viewer or whatever it is. I'm not exactly sure what it is. Okay. For some reason, there were process failures. Open with... All right. Well, my whole computer is slowing down on me, so that is fantastic. Windows Photo Viewer. That's what I'm going to open them with. Make it very, very simple. Hopefully, very quick. So there you go. There's your images, and there's your watermark on the images. And again, all 4 images it is on. There you guys go. And again, as I had mentioned, you guys can do that with any action on Photoshop. So I'm hoping that helped you guys just a little bit. And stay tuned for more Photoshop tutorials here on my channel. There's also a whole playlist if you're interested in learning more Photoshop stuff. It's on my channel. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up if it helped you. Give it a thumbs down also if you want, either way. And definitely don't forget to hit that subscribe button to get notified when I upload more videos. Now, also, I heard along the grapevine here on YouTube that there is an issue with notifications and subscribers not getting notifications. So if you guys want, ring that little bell. You'll get notified every time I upload a video, whether it's a notification to your Google account or it's a notification to your phone, you'll have it there. And I hope I was able to help you guys. Thank you and have a great day.